Meiosis is a type of cell division that consists of two stages. We have meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Now, previously we discussed meiosis 1 and we said that in meiosis 1, the cell undergoes a genetic recombination process known as crossing over, and the cell basically produces or divides into two genetically different haploid cells. So what that means is the following. So this diagram generalizes the process of meiosis 1. So let's suppose we begin with a cell that consists of a single pair of homologous chromosomes shown in the following diagram. So we have pair 1 and chromosome 1 and chromosome 2. So during prophase 1 of meiosis, this homologous pair undergoes the process of crossing over, and we basically form these recombinant chromosomes. And what that basically means is each one of these chromatids are genetically different than the other one. And then the following processes, so we have metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1, and cytokinesis of meiosis 1 basically lead to our division of our cell into these two genetically different haploid cells. Now, haploid means that whatever number of chromosomes we begin with originally, these cells will have half of that number. So in this case, we begin with 1, 2 chromosomes. So that means we'll have half of that. So this will have one chromosome and this will have one chromosome. But notice each one of these chromosomes still consists of two individual chromatids that are genetically different than the other one. So basically in humans, we begin with 46 chromosomes, so each one of these cells will contain only 23 chromosomes. Now, let's move on to the second stage of meiosis known as meiosis 2. And just like mitosis and meiosis 1 are broken down into 4 stages, meiosis 2 can also be broken down into 4 stages or phases. We have prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2, and telophase 2. And we also have the process of cytokinesis, which is actually the separation of the cytoplasm and the cell membrane. Now, the phases of meiosis 2 are actually very similar to the phases of mitosis 2. So if you can remember what mitosis is, you can remember what meiosis 2 is. But there are important differences, as we'll see in just a moment. So let's begin with prophase. Now, the first difference between meiosis 2 and mitosis is that in mitosis, one cell begins our division. But in mitosis 2, these two cells produced in meiosis 1 each basically undergo their own meiosis 2 process. So we have these two genetically different haploid cells as shown that each contain its own chromosome as shown in the following diagram. So basically in prophase 1, our centrioles begin to move to opposite ends. And as they move to opposite ends, they begin to form our spindle apparatus, our spindle fibers that extend towards our chromosome as shown in the following diagram. So let's move on to metaphase 2. In metaphase 2, the spindle fibers form from our centrioles, which are now found on opposite ends of the cell, basically grab our chromosome at the kinetochore region on the centromere. And that is shown in the following diagram. And once they grab it, they align the chromosomes at the center of the cell at our equator, as shown in the following diagram. So in metaphase, the spindle fibers attach to the kinetochore of each chromosome and align the chromosomes along the center of our cell. Now, let's move on to anaphase 2. In anaphase 2, once again, we have the process of disjunction. What happens is our spindle fibers begin to basically contract and they move or separate our two chromatids within our chromosome. So the spindle fibers pull on the chromosome from both ends, separating the chromatids. And notice that unlike in anaphase of mitosis, where we have genetically identical chromatids, in anaphase 2 of meiosis, these two chromatids are genetically different. So this chromatid here is different than this chromatid, and this chromatid is different than this chromatid. And this is one important difference between meiosis 2 and mitosis. And finally, let's move on to telophase. So in telophase 2, the chromatids are now found at opposite poles, at opposite ends of our cell. And the nuclear membrane begins to reform around those chromatids, around our set of chromatids. In this case, we only have one of these chromatids, but in eukaryotic and human cells, we have 23 of these chromatids. So basically, these chromatids are different from one another. And that's exactly why when cytokinesis actually takes place, each one of these haploid cells will be different from one another because they will have different genetic information. So cytokinesis of each cell begins to take place, and then we basically separate our cell membrane and we separate the cytoplasm and the organelles, and we form these two individual distinct cells. And because we have two cells undergoing this process, at the end we form four individual and genetically different haploid cells. So notice we begin with 1, 2 chromosomes. So that means we're only going to have one chromosome because these are haploid cells. So in humans, if we have 46 of these chromosomes, that means each one of these cells will contain only 23 chromatids, which are now known as chromosomes. So basically, let's recap what the entire purpose of meiosis is. So meiosis is a type of cell division in which our beginning cell, the parent cell known as our gametocyte, basically divides into four distinct and genetically different haploid cells. So basically, the underlying process that takes place in meiosis 1 is the crossing over process, in which we basically cross over our genetic information, we exchange our genetic information, and that allows us to produce ultimately these four different haploid cells that each have their own genetic information. So at the end of meiosis, a single gametocyte forms four genetically distinct haploid cells. In humans, these cells contain 23 chromatids, which are now known as chromosomes. So the genetic recombination that occurs in meiosis 1 and the random segregation that takes place in meiosis 1 and 2, that basically allows and provides our cell with the genetic diversity, meaning these cells are different from one another.